My name is Andrea, and it is my honor to officially welcome you to the Summer Games of Soul City Kids Game. And guess what? You get to be an official athlete with the Summer Games. Yes, even from right where you are in your living room, backyard, bedroom, or even at your friend's house. Wherever you are, you can participate in our Summer Games. Each episode of the Summer Games holds a special theme for you to discover, and I'm here to help you with that, along with some of my other friends and our other teammates that you'll meet along the series. Now, in order to get this party started, let's do some warm-ups. Let's get our feet moving. Let's get our heartbeat up. We need to officially kick off these Summer Games with some exercises. Are you ready? We're going to do today's dance of the day as our warm-up. Here we go.
Hey guys, it's Coach King. It's time for the dance of the day. Stand up on your feet with me. Hey DJ, hit that beat. All right, you guys, watch me. One, two, three, clap. One, two, three, clap. You ready? We're gonna do it together. Let's go. One, two, three, clap. One, two, three, clap. Doing great. One more time. Hey, great job, guys. We'll see you next time. Bye.
Woo, great job. I saw you all dancing on your couches. I saw you scaling the walls. Careful on that one. What a workout. Now that we're warmed up, let's go ahead and have a seat because we need to get ready for the introduction of today's summer game. Are you ready? Now, wait a minute, hold on. I almost forgot. You have to pick a country to represent for the summer games. That's right. When we do the summer games at Soul City Kids Camp, each team of campers got to represent a different country in the world. And because you're doing the games from your home, you get to pick your very own country that you're going to compete for. Now, maybe you want to choose the United States. Maybe you want to choose a country that you really want to go to. Maybe you want to choose a country that your grandparents are from. Or maybe you want to choose a country from the Marvel Universe, like Wakanda. Are you ready? Do you know what country you're going to represent? Okay, great. On the count of three, I want to hear the countries that you are representing. One, two, three. Whoa, that is so many different countries that we're representing. That's so great. I'm so glad we have so many campers joining us online for these summer games. Speaking of summer games, I think it's about time we find out what today's game is. So I'm gonna need a drum roll. It's track and field. That's right, track and field is such a multi-purpose sport that lots of different athletes can compete in. Now, track and field is a multi-purpose sport that lots of people can compete in. Now, to get us all prepared for today's activity, I want to introduce you to our very special guest. His name is Coach Nathan, and he's here to tell us all about today's sport. So go ahead and welcome him with three big cheers. Hip, hip.
Hooray!
Hip, hip.
Hooray!
Hip, hip.
Hooray!
Excited you're hosting the summer games with us.
Yeah.
This is great. Now, not many of you may know this, but I happen to be an authentic, genuine expert in the field of track and field. That's right.
Perfect.
I went to Track and Field University to learn all the ins and outs, the who's its and what's its on this sport. And I'm here to prove to you that above all else, in the shadow of a doubt, the key to track and field is silence.
Silence?
Not while I'm coaching. In order to get the proper function of track and field, first, you need to find a field, which I see right behind me. We have a field in this jumbo stadium right here. All right. So what happens is this. When I say go, Andrea is going to release a bunch of hyper squirrels all hopped up on coffee grounds. Then you'll use your stealth tracking skills to track them down.
Coach Nathan.
I know. You're probably wondering where we're going to get these squirrels, but not to worry. I've already wrangled up a bunch of them from the parks around the West Loop here in Chicago. Some of them are biters, but they're feeding on the coffee grounds right now. And we're almost ready to be released for you kids to go and catch. They'll track them down in the field. Track and field.
I see what you did there. But yeah, Soul City Kids, I need your help. I think Coach Nathan is a little confused about what this sport is all about. Do you think so too? I think we need some leaders that can help Coach Nathan learn the right way to do the different games of track and field. You know, sometimes I need help. I like to turn and look at one of the greatest leaders of all times. I've gotten to know more about this leader when I've come to church at Soul City, when I meet with some of the other leaders here, and when I read my Bible. Do you know who it is I'm talking about? Who this great leader is? That's right, it's Jesus. Jesus had a group of people follow him and learn from him. This group of people were called his disciples. In fact, I know of a great story that showcases one of the virtues of being a disciple, a follower of Jesus. Let's take a look at it.
Hello everyone, I'm Jared.
I'm Andrew.
And we're here to tell you a Bible story. Our story is about one of the most famous heroes in all of the Bible, King David. But our story begins long before David is king, so let's rewind to when David was just a boy. Now, David was the youngest of eight brothers, so he had to do the jobs that nobody else wanted to do, like taking care of his father's sheep. Gross.
Hey, sheep's gotta do what a sheep's gotta do.
It turned out that David was actually a really good shepherd. In fact, one day, a lion attacked the sheep.
Meow.
What was that?
You said it was like a cat attack, right? Like...
No, a lion, a ferocious lion.
Oh, like a...
Much better. But David fought back and he killed the lion.
I'm dead.
Then, another day, a bear attacked the sheep. What was that?
I can barely do that sound.
But David fought back and he killed the bear too.
I'm dead too.
While David was taking care of his father's sheep, his brothers had a much more important job. They were in the Israelite army, preparing for an epic battle.
Get to the chopper!
What was all of that?
What are you talking about? You said they're in a battle! Epic battle!
Yes, but this took place a long time ago.
Okay.
Bible times.
Yeah.
No guns, no bombs, no choppers.
What'd they have?
It was like swords. While his brothers were preparing for this epic battle with swords, David's father was concerned about them. So he sent David on an errand to bring them some food. David gathered some grain and some bread and some cheese. When David brought the food to his brothers, they were all hiding. Because out on the battlefield, there was a giant with a massive sword. He was shielded in bronze.
Bronze.
He stood 10 feet tall.
10 feet.
And his name was...
Goliath.
Why are you talking like that?
That's how giants talk.
And how do you know this?
I saw it on the History Channel.
When David arrived on the battlefield, Goliath was insulting the people of God, even cursing God himself.
Goliath's a cusser?
None of the other soldiers wanted to fight Goliath because they were all too afraid. But David wasn't. David knew with God on his side, Goliath didn't stand a chance. David came up with a plan. He went down to a stream and he chose 5 smooth stones.
Okay, here I am at the stream. Need 5 smooth stones. Let's see. 1, okay. That's pretty smooth. Keep that one. Okay. 2. Nope, too jaggedy. Whoa.
Andrew, what is that?
It's a fish. I grabbed the fish on accident. What do I do?
Just put it back.
What?
Well, just put it back.
Okay. Let's see. That one's pretty good. Let's see. Oh, hey. This one's squishy.
That's a frog.
Ah! I'm keeping it.
Well, no, don't. Okay.
And see, good to go. Let's go kill a giant.
David marched to the battlefield right toward the giant. When Goliath saw him coming, he started to make fun of David. But David wasn't bothered by what Goliath said because David knew who God said he was. And with God on his side, Goliath didn't stand a chance. David reached into his bag and he pulled out a stone. Still got the frog, don't you?
Yeah, he's real cute.
Andrew, could you just get rid of the frog, please?
Excuse me, his name is Carlos.
Andrew, could you get rid of Carlos, please?
Okay, fine.
No, Andrew! Andrew, spit it out. Spit the frog out. Mm-mm. Andrew, spit it out. Mm-mm. Spit him out. Did you just eat that frog?
That's really salty.
David reached in his pouch and he pulled out a stone. He put it in his sling and he spun it around above his head. Just then, Goliath drew his massive sword and charged. The giant stormed across the battlefield right towards David. But David held his ground because he knew who God said he was. As Goliath got closer, David began to swing faster and faster and faster, waiting for the perfect shot. He took a deep breath and he let it rip. What was that?
What are you talking about? You said he let it rip, right?
No! Like he threw the rock, he let it fly!
Oh! Like...
Yes.
Like that kind of let it... I'm sorry, that's my bad. That's me. I'm sorry. Keep going, just get back to the story.
The stone flew through the air and hit Goliath right between the eyes. The stone sunk deep into his head and Goliath fell to the ground. Andrew, you okay?
I'm dead.
Then how are you talking?
I'm a ghost.
Come on, man. Let's finish the story.
Okay.
That day, David showed everyone that even though he was just a boy, he could still do the great things that God had planned for him. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is the story of David and Goliath.
Wow, even though David wasn't a soldier and he was smaller than Goliath, and I mean, a lot smaller, he still wanted to face him because he knew with God, he would be victorious. In fact, that's our big idea for Summer Games today. A disciple is victorious. Even though David was alive before Jesus was born, he still had the heart of a champion because he listened to and followed God. And because he listened to and followed God, he knew that no matter what happened, he would be victorious. So Coach Nathan, even though you may be a little confused about how to play today's summer game of track and field, just know that we still want you to be on our team and we want to help you out in figuring it out. So as we all work together to learn more about Jesus and why he had disciples, we can grow in our friendship with him too.
You know, that sounds great. I'll tell you what, kids, you go and learn some activities that have to do with our summer game of track and field. Then you can make a video and tell me the right way to play it. It'll help me learn and grow.
That's right. You can also go deeper in the Bible and talk with your family about the Bible story. Watch this video with your family and try to find where you see God in the story. Where do you see the victory we're talking about? Now remember, a good athlete trains, learns, and grows. They aren't afraid of asking questions and growing in their understanding of the game, just like we're not afraid to grow in our understanding of our faith. But before you go, let's all stand up together and sing along to our brand new kids camp song, The Heart of a Champion.
When I'm standing in the shadow of the tallest mountain, I'm not worried I won't make it to the top. When I'm staring in the face of the scariest giant, I'm not scared, cause I'm never gonna stop. This one thing is true, I can do all things when I'm with you. My Jesus is stronger. So the lowest valley, I know I won't ever walk alone. This one thing is true, I can do all things when I'm with you. My Jesus is stronger, and I know he'll carry me through. With the heart of the champion, there's no battle we can win.
Great job singing, Soul City campers. We can't wait to see your videos and to see you in the very next episode. Until then, remember that as a disciple, we are victorious.